Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss fluocinolone acetonide. What is this drug fluocinolone? Fluocinolone is one of the corticosteroids. We can observe the suffix lone just like the prednisolone. So fluocinolone is a corticosteroid. And this drug is available as acetonide where it forms diester with acetone. Now, what is the use of this fluocinolone acetonide? Since it is a corticosteroid, this drug acts as anti-inflammatory agent. Therefore, fluocinolone acetonide can be used in the various skin conditions which are associated with allergic as well as inflammatory reactions. So, this drug can be used in the treatment of eczema, dermatitis, pruritus. Even it can be used in other conditions like plaque psoriasis. In this way, in many of the skin inflammatory disorders, fluocinolone acetonide can be used. But this drug should be carefully used in the children because this drug increases the systemic absorption in the children, resulting in few of the systemic complications. And this drug is available in different dosage forms such as ointment or cream. It's also available as lotion. All these can be applied topically. Interestingly, this drug is also useful in the treatment of diabetic macular edema, where accumulation of retinal fluids are observed in the diabetic people, resulting in the edema. In such conditions, fluocinolone acetonide can be given by implant, where it reduces the edema by producing vasoconstriction. So this is one of the advantages of this drug. Fluocinolone is having vasoconstrictive properties by which it can reduce the inflammation as well as edema. Thereby, it can be used as anti-inflammatory agent in various skin disorders. So, today in this video, we are going to see how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, doses, chemical nature, and important precautions of this drug. All these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, it is the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of fluocinolone acetonide is that when this drug is given by topical route, it is going to be applied on the skin where irritation or inflammation exists. In such conditions, this drug can be applied as a thin film on the skin, but few of the molecules can be absorbed into the deeper layer and they can be entered into the systemic circulation. So, this systemic absorption of this drug may produce few of the systemic side effects, which are more pronounced with increased dose of this drug and increased applied area. So, when this drug is applied at larger doses and larger surface area, the systemic absorption is more pronounced, leading to more significant systemic side effects. And this systemic absorption is also more pronounced in the children, where the drug can be easily absorbed into the skin. That's why in the children, this drug should be carefully used. So, care should be taken to reduce the systemic absorption. But when this drug is absorbed into the systemic circulation, it can suppress the HPA axis, hypothalamus pituitary adrenal axis, so that the release of cortisol is somewhat reduced, which results in various systemic side effects. So, by suppression of HPA axis, fluocinolone acetonide can produce a variety of conditions commonly known as Cushing syndrome. So, this drug can develop the symptoms just like the Cushing syndrome, resulting in development of moon face, weight gain, increased blood pressure resulting in hypertension, increased glucose levels resulting in hyperglycemia. All these conditions can be observed. And within the children, it can also produce mental retardation and retardation of the growth. All this because of enhanced systemic exposure of this drug. That's why this drug should be carefully used by topical route. Under optimal conditions, the systemic exposure can be reduced. But when this drug is used at very high dose, and when it is applied as a thick film on larger surface area, the systemic absorption may be increased, resulting in the development of these symptoms. And the systemic absorption can be further increased with surgical dressings and occlusal dressings like bandages. They further increase the systemic absorption of fluocinolone acetonide, resulting in the increased development of symptoms like Cushing syndrome. So, caution should be taken while using the occlusal dressings with fluocinolone acetonide. But these occlusive dressings are somewhat advantageous in few of the conditions like psoriasis, where they reduce exposure to the atmosphere, thereby they increase the healing rate with this drug. But in case of development of any infections, these occlusive dressings should not be used as they further increase the infections as well as increase the systemic absorption. So except in the conditions like psoriasis, occlusive dressings are not preferred with fluocinolone acetonide. And the important precaution is that this drug, when applied locally, it can produce local skin reactions resulting in striae formation, skin atrophy, acne-type skin eruptions, and skin irritation can be observed with this fluocinolone acetonide. Now let us see the side effects of this drug. The important side effects mainly include the local reactions. It can produce some burning sensation, itching, irritation, dryness of the skin can be produced by this drug. And it can also produce enhancement of the hair growth at the applied area. Hyperpigmentation can be observed, resulting in few of the light spots as well as red spots on the skin. And it can also produce maceration of the skin, resulting in skin atrophy. And finally, it can also produce some allergic contact dermatitis. All these are the local skin reactions produced by fluocinolone acetonide. Now let us see how this drug acts. Few of the inflammatory mediators can act on the corresponding receptors expressed on inflammatory cells. So when they are going to act on these receptors, they can stimulate one of the pathway, NFKB, nuclear factor kappa B. This NFKB can interact with the DNA within the nucleus, resulting in gene transcription and release of few of the inflammatory mediators which produce the inflammation. Now fluocinolone acetonide can act as corticosteroid. So it can act on the glucocorticoid receptors which are coupled with one of the protein, heat shock protein 90. Now fluocinolone can enter into the cell and it can bind to the glucocorticoid receptors where HSP90 is detached and these receptors are internalized into the nucleus. Within the nucleus, they can be dimerized and they can interact with glucocorticoid response elements which produce a gene transcription, thereby they release one of the mRNA which is coding for various anti-inflammatory mediators. Now this mRNA can undergo protein synthesis, thereby it can release few of the mediators such as lipocortin 1 and annexin A1. These are the anti-inflammatory mediators which can reduce the inflammation, thereby they can reduce the swelling, redness and itching of the skin. And this drug can also block the NFKB pathway, thereby it can reduce the release of inflammatory mediators. Generally, whenever there is an inflammation, the inflammatory stimuli can stimulate one of the enzyme, phospholipase A2. This phospholipase A2 is a cleavage enzyme which can cleave the phospholipids such that it is going to be converted into one of the mediator, arachidonic acid. This arachidonic acid is a C20 fatty acid which is then going to be interacted with the COX enzyme such that it can be converted into various types of mediators such as PGE2, PGI2 and thromboxane A2. These are the prostaglandins and thromboxanes which increase the inflammation, swelling and vasodilatation. Now fluocinolone acetonide acts as anti-inflammatory agent. It can induce one of the enzyme annexin A1. This annexin A1 can block the activity of phospholipase A2, thereby it can reduce the release of prostaglandins. And this drug can also directly inhibit the COX enzyme activity, thereby the synthesis of prostaglandins is reduced. By all of these actions, fluocinolone acetonide acts as anti-inflammatory agent. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of fluocinolone acetonide. Here the basic nucleus is the prignane, just like in the prednisolone, and with two double bonds and two ketone groups. So we can write this as prigna-1,4-diene-320-dione. And it is having the fluorine groups at 6th position as well as another fluorine group at the 9th position. So this is 6,9-difluoro. And here we can observe the two hydroxyl groups attached adjacently on the two carbons. They can be esterified with the acetone such that they form the acetonide. So this is the simple structure of fluocinolone acetonide. Now let us see how it is given. Fluocinolone acetonide is available as ointment at a strength of 0.025%. It is also available as cream. And even it is available as a lotion at a strength of 0.01%. This drug should be applied as a thin film on the affected area. And it can be applied around 2 to 4 times daily. But the low dose of the drug should be used in order to reduce the systemic absorption. And in the conditions like psoriasis, occlusive dressings can be used But in other skin inflammatory disorders, occlusive dressings are not preferred as they increase the systemic absorption. And in the children, this drug should be carefully used to prevent systemic exposure and suppression of HP axis. So that's all about this drug, fluocinolone acetonide, which is a corticosteroid which can be applied topically in order to treat various types of skin inflammatory disorders. This drug is also available as an implant to treat the conditions like diabetic macular edema, and it can also be used for a few of the ocular inflammatory disorders. But when it is applied on the eye, it can increase the risk of development of cataracts. But when it is applied topically, it can produce few of the local skin reactions resulting in burning sensation, stinging, redness, dryness of the skin and skin atrophy. One of the important precautions of this drug is the suppression of HP axis due to the systemic absorption of this drug, particularly more pronounced in the children due to increased permeability of the skin. So that's all about this drug, fluocinolone acetonide. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.